Okay, guys, welcome back to part two of Shadaloo Bootcamp, where we'll be covering Vega's combo guide. If you missed out on parts one, you can check out the links on the screen or in the description below. Here we're going to be covering Vega's counter hit combos from lights to heavies, with and without claw. So you're in for a treat. Let's go on with part two. Now we're gonna go on to Vega's counter hit combos off of light attacks when he has the claw. He has a certain amount of combos. We're gonna go over them right now. One of them being his crouching light punch. You can now combo on counter hit. You can combo into crouching strong. As said earlier, you cannot cancel this and his crouching strong, crouching medium punch into anything except V trigger. So we're gonna go ahead and we got this one, and we also have crouching light kick into crouching medium punch, and standing light kick into crouching medium punch. Now, those are good combos, but he has something better, which gives you an even better time for confirms or frame traps, and it's that you can do crouching light punch into crouching medium punch. The good thing about that is that you can come right after with your crouching strong. See? You can also do crouching medium kick after a standing light punch. So, into the trigger if you want to extend the combo, because we all know that you can't cancel crouching medium kick. And you can even combo his anti-air V trigger as well, because it has mad ray hands. So, with regards to claw, that's pretty much his counter hit combos with claw off of light attacks. Now we're gonna go to those counter hit combos without the claw when he's in counter hits. Okay, with Vega, when he doesn't have the claw, his combos from counter hits. He can't do crouching jab into crouching medium kick. He can still do standing jab into crouching medium kick. That does count. But his range on his crouching strong is shorter, so he can't do the same combo that he does in claw. Okay? But he has something that's relatively better, and is that crouching light kick is plus 6 on counter hit, crouching light punch is plus 6 on counter hit, crouching standing light punch is plus 7, which is why we can do this, and standing light kick is also plus 6. Guess what move is plus 6? Standing medium punch. So let's go over easy combos. Like, you can do crouching jab into crouching strong. That is a counter hit combo, right? You can do crouching light kick into crouching strong. You can do stand light kick into crouching strong. Those are counter hit combos, but you can go even further. You can do crouching jab into his target combo, which starts off with standing strong, which comes out at 6. And then you can go for EX Barcelona. Very good damage. And you can also do it off of a counter hit crouching light kick, or a counter hit standing light kick, or a counter hit standing jab. So all of his light attacks on counter hit are relatively plus 6, except for a standing light punch, which is actually plus 7. So all of those moves on counter hit let you combo into his target combo. So be sure to have fun with that, because you will get good damage. Now, that being said, that's pretty much his combos off of light attacks on counter hit. So now we're gonna go on to his combos on counter hits after medium attacks with claw first, and then we will go without the claw. Okay, so now his combos with medium attacks when he is in his counter hit. Okay, so he has, I already showed that he can do medium punch into crouching medium punch, but on counter hit he can actually do standing medium punch into standing medium punch. There we go. He also has crouching medium punch into crouching jab. You also have that. And you can go into the crouching jab into EX Barcelona. That's one of his counter combos as well. But the most He also has this one. Let's not build that far so fast. Yeah, standing medium kick into crunchy strong as well. But here are the good things. He can do standing medium punch into standing high punch. Heavy punch. So, you can do something like that. You can also do something like this. Let's do this one. Alright, we can do that. Which is standing medium punch into standing heavy punch, target combo into the skill. Or we could do this one as well, which is claw switch into crouching medium as well. So, let's do that one. This is not gonna combo because you're too far. Because the medium punch pushes you far. But you can do EX Barcelona or EX Crimson Terror, I think you can also do that. Let's do EX Crimson Terror. Yes, you can. I love that hitbox, I'll be honest. Right? So we have good damage. Another combo besides the strong into heavy is that you can do crouching medium kick into heavy punch, and you can do the same thing. Either you do the target combo, right? Let's see if I get it. Oh, it's too slow, Mono. Right, we got that one. Or we can go for the extra damage, and we do his claw switch. See if we get that. Into EX Crimson Terror or EX Barcelona, whichever you want. Because you're too, I'm not sure if you're too far. No, you're not. You're actually not too far to do medium Crimson Terror, so you don't get to waste meter. That's really good. So, let's see if we can do, let's see if I get this. You can also do that. Which is medium Crimson Terror, and you cancel the first hit into critical arc. So, that's pretty much all of his combos after counter hit strong. I mean, counter hit medium attacks. Let me just make sure if we covered all of them. Yes, with Claw, those are pretty much all of his combos after medium attacks. Except for one more, let's see. Which is this one. There is one more. And I think it's standing like this one. I remember I was having trouble with doing it because I was doing the... Yep. You can do that one. But this one's gonna be hard to link, just letting you know. Because see, if you do the double input too fast, he's gonna do a... There we go. But, fortunately, you don't get the EX Barcelona. So that sucks. Anyways, those are pretty much the combos he has. And now we're gonna go with medium attacks on counter hit without the claw. So now we're gonna go with his combos on counter hit after medium attacks without the claw. Now, Vega, crouching medium punch, really good. On counter hit, you can combo into another crouching medium punch, or you can combo into his target combo as well. Because this is actually around plus six, more or less. Yeah. Okay, so you can combo this, and you can combo another crouch. Another thing you can do is crouching medium kick into crouching medium kick. But you're too far to land either crouching strong or standing strong. So if you land this, you might as well just go for his normal combo, which that is a normal combo of his. His target combo, you can also combo it without the counter hit. You can also do stand medium kick into crouching medium punch, or stand medium kick into medium hit. His target combo of stand medium punch into heavy kick. Let's see. Stand medium punch. You can link it into crouching medium punch, but you can't link it into another standing medium punch. I wish he could do this, but he cannot. If you land a meaty counter hit, possibly, but we will check those out when we get to meaties. Remember, you can cancel, just so you know, stand medium punch, crouching medium punch, into medium bars, comes in terror, does not combo, because you're too far. So, you're gonna have to go, sorry, into his EX Crimson Terror or EX Barcelona. Okay, so keep that in mind when you're doing these combos. Now, crouching medium kick, unfortunately, cannot be canceled. So, except the trigger. So keep that in mind, that if you do the crouching medium kick, you can do another one, but you can only cancel it into the trigger. So remember that. That medium kick actually leaves you a bit closer, so you could do his medium Crimson Terror. And crouching medium punch is a crouching medium punch. Does not push you away either. So you can also do it. So now we're gonna go to combos off of heavies on counter hit with claw. So this is one of the combos that he has. He can do standing heavy punch into crouching medium punch. He can also do stand heavy punch into crouching medium kick, which is really good, because then you get your crouching medium punch right after. But the most important ones are when you're doing claw switch, which is even better. So you can do, you know that on normal, he can only do claw switch into crouching medium punch, but when it's on counter hit, you can actually do his crouching medium kick, which is even better because that will extend your combos to the point that you can do something like this. And you can cancel that into Crimson Terror. Okay. Now, that was light Crimson Terror. So let's do medium. Apparently medium is too slow. So you can only do your light Crimson Terror. So remember that. Also, another combo that he has, which is my personal favorite, is that you can do counter hit standing fierce, crouching medium kick into his target combo, and then you can go for an EX Barcelona or V-trigger. Let's do that again, and let's finish it with the EX Barcelona so we can see what he does. And the damage is 349. That's a lot of damage off of one EX special. Now, I think he has one more. Let me just check the list really quick. And actually no, that's pretty much what I got. Because counter hits, crush counter, we're gonna go specifically, because obviously we know that the roundhouse is indeed on counter hit. You can do certain combos. Yeah, you can't combo off of that, except when you don't have the claw, you can actually combo, but we'll show that soon. So, counter hit combos and crush counter combos are a different section. This move, we will cover it on the crush counter section. Okay, so now we're gonna cover his counter hits with the exclusion of the crush counters, because the crush counters, I'm gonna do it as an additional section as well, so that we can just focus on crush counter combos only, and not mix them up with all the counter hits, even though the effect does go with the counter hit. So we're gonna cover now his combos off of counter hit heavy attacks, only those that do not cause crush counter. So, standing fierce, really good move. You can, combos that you can get off of a counter hit standing fierce are crouching medium punch, but you're too far. So we're already aware that probably light and medium Crimson Terror are not that combo. So we're gonna have to go for EX Crimson Terror or EX Barcelona. Okay, so another combo that he has, which is a lot better, so if you get a counter hit, you're gonna go straight into his target combo. Because you can combo that too. So you get standing fierce, target combo, V-trigger, or EX Barcelona, whichever you prefer. But there is one that is definitely one of my favorites. This is a specific one that he has, crouching fierce. You can't combo it in any of the situations, except when he's without the claw and it's a counter hit. You can do, it's actually +3 when you land it as a counter hit. So you can do crouching fierce into standing down. See? But this is a problem, right? You can't combo that. But you can combo his EX Barcelona, because it comes out relatively fast. But V-Trigger, remember what I said about the V-Trigger, that when you do his crouching V-Trigger, his entire V-Trigger, it actually has more range? Well, that will combo. See? So that's one of the combos. Now, my personal favorite combo, which is definitely going to be your favorite combo, and you're going to try to look for it, is if you land the Standing Fierce on counter hit and you do Claw Switch, you can do Standing Fierce with Claw as well, and then do another Claw Switch. So you get two Claw Switches in one combo. To me, that's like the sickest one. So let's just show this one really quick. It's Standing Fierce in Claw Switch, Standing Fierce, Claw Switch, Crouching Strong into Medium Crimson Terror. So let's go for it now. As you can see, I'm doing a double Claw Switch. See? And the damage is 298. So, but we can do the extra damage and we can do. Ah, I wanted to do EX. Barcelona. Well, we got EX in terror and we're already at 300. Ooh, 350 something from the EX Barcelona. Yeesh. And what happens if we do V trigger? If we do the ground V trigger, obviously into super, this is gonna be ridiculous, so let's do it just once. That is definitely more than half your life. Definitely more than half your life. That is definitely more than half your life. Wow. There you go.
This character is too good.
I'm sorry, guys. It's too good. So, crush counter moves with the claw. When he has the claw, his crush counter moves are Core Fierce, Slide, and Standing Roundhouse. This move moves forward, so it's really good. Now, when you land this move, it does the spin, right? And so does the Forward Fierce. They both do the spin. They don't do the stagger knockdown that certain characters like Bison and, Bison, pretty much I covered, and Alex, Standing Roundhouse. So, with Vega, I'm going to show a few combos after the crush counter. You can do, if you land it really far, you can just walk up and do another one. But remember that you can link right after it. So you can do something like crouching jab right after. If you're close enough, you can go into the light Crimson Terror. But if you're far, you could try to do that into EX Barcelona. Right, and we get that, and that's 337. Or the basic combo is that you walk forward and you do Stand Fierce. You can do his target combo into V skill, or you can do the cross switch combo, right? And go for that. Another one that you have is that you can do this. If you land it really far, you can do that. You can't cancel that move, except V trigger. So it's really good if you land it really far. If you land this really far, I think that the one to do is actually that one. If it's too far. See? Because the problem with this is that this is the problem. You would have to walk just a bit and leave neutral, because if you leave forward, see? If you leave forward, you're gonna get that. And you're gonna miss your combo opportunity. So, keep in mind that if you land this really far, look at the difference. I'm gonna try to do the fierce into medium, but you're gonna see that the light crimson, the crimson terror is not gonna hit. You, not as easy. That's why I'm saying that. If you land this really far, it's better to just walk up and do the roundhouse. See? Because it's always going to hit. See? You're too far, so you can't really hit. So I would recommend that if you land this too far, go for another one and try to walk up as much as you can so you get the crouching jab. And after that, you get the EX Barcelona. The good thing about that is that you don't really risk it in the sense that if you buffer it really fast, see, I don't know if you noticed, see, if you buffer the EX Barcelona extremely fast, it's not gonna come out unless it hits. It should not, at least. See? I did it right there. So keep that in mind. This is a good go-to combo if you're max range. Or you could just do that into slide. If you land it really far, you can just go for the and not complicate your life. Just do slide. So another crush counter that he has with claw, like I said, is his forward fierce. And I already showed you that you can do the claw switch, that you can do this one. Right? And the other one is this one. Now, after this, you really do not have that many combos. You pretty much just have to slide, and that's about it. Because the farther you are, it's even harder. If you land it like max range, you got nothing at all. Except maybe. That's it. V trigger. And you can, I think you can late cancel it too. Like from that distance. The thing is that when you cancel it, he like stays closer. And I think you can cancel it at different. Like a bit later after the crush counter effect. But one thing that you can also do, but this is if you land it close. Like let's say, like, let's try to do this. Let's land the back throw. And we're gonna put him not the block, and it's gonna be counter hit. He's too far, right? Forward. He's there. I think that at that distance, you can actually combo forward fierce into his critical arc, but you have to be relatively close. But it's only close, okay? See, there it's been comboed. But if you do it from... I'll check up setups later on, but I'm just going to show you the fact that it can combo, okay? So let's just show it really quick. So, forward fierce into critical arc. Sorry. See? Combo right there. Two hits. There should be relative frame traps where you can actually use it, because I know that people sometimes chase you down with it, with the forward pierce. You just have to find out what is a good setup that leaves you close enough so that you can link it to the critical arc. It's risky because if you miss it, you're gonna get hell of a punish. So just go for this. Only if you really need that clutch and you're gonna bet it all, then and you know that you're close, then go for the super. And then get the combo right out of it. Unfortunately, you cannot combo into EX Barcelona after the forward pierce, but it's good to know the fact that you can do that. Because that's true. No matter how fast I try to do it, it's not gonna hit. See? So Vega without the claw, crush counters. Now when he doesn't have the claw, he has one less crush counter move because he does not have his forward pierce when he doesn't have the claw. So you only have slide, which leads to no combos, and standing roundhouse. Now standing roundhouse, you actually get an even better combo in which you are not required to waste meter, technically. And it's that you can do crush counter roundhouse into roundhouse. And remember, since it's plus 4, you can combo into his standing light punch, and then you can link his crouching strong. So let's show that combo really quick. See? So that's a really good combo. Into medium Crimson Terror, if you're close enough. And if you're far, you're not gonna get it. But it's good to know, right? So, again. That's one of him, of his combos. You can also do stand roundhouse into his target combo. which is standing strong into a roundhouse heavy kick. So that one you can just go ahead and go into EX Barcelona for that extra damage. It's 350, right?
That's really good damage.
You can also do off of his crush counter, you can do Fierce into Claw Switch as well. You can do... And go ahead for the critical art if you want that extra damage. And I am pretty sure I am missing one. Let's check out the list just to make sure. I did the Crouching Mew Punch into... No, that's pretty much it, because the other one, I already covered it when I was with Claw, which is his basic combo, which is roundhouse. So. Oh, you can also do this. Forgot. You can walk up. Right? You can do roundhouse, crouching medium kick, and target combo. I believe that's the most damaging. Is actually, that's 361, right? I believe that the most damaging would be this one. Let's try it just to compare, right? No, actually, the most damaging was the one with the crushing move. So now you know that you can do it. So if you don't know, now you know. There we go. So that's pretty much all of his combos off crush counter roundhouse when he does not have the claw. And maybe not all of the combos, but the combos that are most important. Because I'm pretty sure well, you can do like a lot of stuff, like you can just go for jabs. You can do something like that. But the damage is not really worth it. So I'm just putting in the important ones, or the ones that should be most practical. Because if you're going to be really practical, then you can just go ahead and go into Crouching Strong and just avoid the whole thing. But the really most basic combo that you can do off the crush counter roundhouse would be target combo right after, because it's simple. Or if you want to get the extra damage, then you do that. With special attacks, we covered with claw. Now without claw, the difference is with claw, this knocks you down, right? And you do the Aurora spin. Or V trigger or super critical art. Now when you don't have the claw, he doesn't knock you down, which gives you combo possibilities. So after this, you actually combo right after. In this case, with Vega, you can obviously do his jabs, but we can obviously extend these combos a bit more and get more damage. So you can do something like that was standing strong into medium Crimson Terror, or you can do crouching strong into medium Crimson Terror. You can do his target combo from one Barcelona to the next. Or if you want the extra damage, it would be this one. This one's the most damaging. Which is the Barcelona follow-up into crouching medium kick into target combo into EX Barcelona, and you get a good 313 damage. So another one that he has is the EX version, which has more hit stun. See? And you can do a standing fierce, because normally you can combo into a standing fierce. It has to be, unless if it hits counter hit. If it does a counter hit, you can do a standing fierce. But EX Barcelona has even more ridiculous priority. And you go for that. And there we go. And the other combo that he has is Claw Switch. You can actually do a Claw Switch combo. Okay. And you can do Crouching Strong into V-Trigger because you can't cancel into anything else. Or you could do Crouching Light Punch into Light Crimson Terror. Let's do that one. Missed it right there. Okay, and you waste no meter at all, nor V-Trigger. Or we can do the V-Trigger combo with this. Oops. I missed that one. So one more time. See? Oh my god. do it one more time. There we go. One more time. We're gonna celebrate. I'm celebrating till I got it. So I'm sorry for the tedious attempt. So let's see if I covered pretty much all of it. And you know that I use the heavies and strong attacks, medium attacks, so that you guys can see that up to what extent you can combo. But clearly, if you can combo medium attacks, you can definitely combo his light attacks because they come out even faster. Like I showed that I did claw switch and then I did crouching light punch into light Crimson Terror, because like that is the combo that you can do with less meter. You don't have to waste meter, and you don't have to waste, well, I did kind of waste meter because I did the EX, but if you can't waste an additional EX or you don't have the V trigger, then you can just go into crouching light punch into light Crimson Terror, because since the light punch, you can actually cancel it into special moves when you have the claw, then it's the most advantage. Gives you the most advantage. Now, that was special attacks without the claw. So I'm just gonna go ahead and show it on counter hit, because with Vega, doing counter hit EX Barcelona with claw is the same thing. There's nothing different about it. I'm still gonna combo the same stuff. So, but, when you don't have the claw, that one on counter hit, you can actually combo his standing fierce. See? Go to it. Into a roundhouse. And then you can do that kind of setup where you cross them up. Those setups will be on the next upcoming episode, which is for mix-ups and frame traps and all that. So for now, I just gave a hint, but that's pretty much it. You can also do this into claw switch as well. Into crouching light punch, into light Crimson Terror, or you can do into crouching strong, into V-trigger and all that. See? So, what else can we do? Now, the EX version, like if you know that we can combo his standing fierce, well, obviously we might be able to combo a bit more. But there's really no real point to it, I guess. I mean, the frame advantage is ridiculous. See right there? Blocked it. There we go. You can do probably that one. So you can do something like that, yeah. See, this doesn't combo, I think, let me try it one more. See, it doesn't combo on counter hit, even if it's normal, but the EX one, most probably, you will be able to combo. See? And the good thing about that one is that you can do something like this. Sorry, not this thing. You can do standing light punch. You can do standing light punch into his... You can do stand roundhouse, stand light punch, crouching strong. See? You can do that combo. That combo's really good. Let me just make sure that it wasn't... You can also do it without the counter hit, so it doesn't make that... It doesn't really make a difference. But now you know that you can actually extend your damage, so you can do something like... You have to do that really early. Okay. So you get that combo, so that's really good. So, one more time. 327. That's really good, actually. The thing is that, obviously, this does not hit crouching opponents. And neither does your target. This is very important for you to know, because you will not be able, you will get punished for this. Because if the person reacts in time, you're gonna get punished. So, that pretty much covers all of his combos. Without the claw, when he comes off from a special attack. Also, I covered counter hit in the same section, pretty much because there is no counter hit combos with claw when it comes to special attacks, so that's why I did it. Now we're gonna move on to his meaty combos and meaty counter hits. And then after that, it's V-Trigger, but I'm just gonna be honest, his V-Trigger is an attack. It's not really a state, like with the characters that we've already covered, which was Alex and Bison and Fang, which actually is a state that lasts. So pretty much you can just combo anything into V-Trigger, but we'll show that soon. Okay, so that's a wrap for part two, where we covered Vega's counter hits. Remember, if you missed out on part one, you can check on the links on the screen or in the description below. Part three will be available during the week, so you can click also on the link. If you liked the video, make sure to give us a like, comment on the section below if you guys like the format that we're doing, and subscribe to Gamers Group TV channel so you can be up to date every time a new video and new content is available. And be sure to follow us on Twitter, at MonoPR, or at Gamers Group TV. That being said, I'll see you guys in part three, where we'll be covering meaty attacks and V-Trigger combos.